what a great message, great message of hope to whoever's watching the broadcast today, that no matter what kind of background you have, no matter where you came, Jesus can redeem it.
Yep.
And in fact, God has the power. He's the only one who has the power to take our mess and turn it into a message.
Amen.
And and literally and just redeem everything and use it for His glory and His honor. And both of your whole family and just the ministry God's entrusted to you is a great testimony to the glory and honor of God. So God's using you on the streets, touching hearts, bringing people to the kingdom of God, influencing gangs. God's given you the inroads into the political realm. And I think that's what the kingdom's supposed to be doing. It's supposed to be changing all different spheres of our world. And then you talked about how God's using you to bring unity among the body of Christ and outside of that also. Yeah. And I think, why don't you, Pastor Al, talk a little bit about that and this, and then go ahead and just share whatever you feel like the Lord's laid upon your heart, what the Holy Spirit is just saying to the church or somebody that might be watching the broadcast today.
Well, one thing we always try to do is let everybody know the message never changes.
Yes.
The method might change.
Yes.
And the method that we have might not be the same as everybody else's, but the message never changes. You cannot have a transformed life unless Jesus is in your life.
Amen.
And that's one thing that we teach and we believe and we walk it in the ministry. The integrity has to be there.
Yes.
And that's one thing that we believe in. Mm. And we know that God has called us to the ministry at this time because He orchestrates everything.
Yes.
He brings everything. Even us being here today, it was not our choice. It was His choice to put us here.
Amen.
To bring forth and let them know, hey, God is a God of second chances, third chances, fourth chances, you know.
I'll just interject. I actually had other guests scheduled for today, and they called up, and for whatever reason, they were unable to make it. And so that's when I called you earlier this week. So I really do, Pastor, I really believe that you guys are here on this day.
I believe that too.
Because it's the will of God for you to be on the show today and not like next month or a few months from now. So this really is, I believe, for those that are watching the broadcast, this is a very, very strategic, divine moment in the kingdom of God. So go ahead.
And God has always also taken us in a place where we deal with different denominations.
Yes.
And different pastors.
Yes.
That I have sat down and talked with them, prayed with them, have different ideas. And it's all God orchestrated for a time such as this.
Yes.
Because it is time for us, like you were saying before about John describing heaven, you know, the let the wall be there because these people think they're the only ones here. But in Revelation 7, it tells us that John heard a sound of a roaring, like an ocean.
Yes.
And when he turned around, he saw people of all nations, of all tongues, of all kindred.
Hallelujah.
He didn't say, I saw Methodists, I saw Baptists, I saw Catholic.
That's
no.
Right. That's
he
right.
said, I saw men and women of all different tongues and nations.
Yes.
That's the body of Christ.
Amen.
And that's what the message that we try to bring is that we need unity, not just in the churches, in the streets, to be able to take the message to them.
Yes.
But first, we have to have that relationship that we may go and tell them, look what God has done for me. Look what God has done for my son.
Yeah.
He brought him along in this ministry that I was kind of reluctant, like he said before. And I even told him one time, I said, you go, I'll stay back and I'll pray. But God had everything arranged.
Yes.
So right now, we're just thanking God for this opportunity to be able to be with you.
Yeah.
Because I met you not too long ago.
Yeah.
But the Spirit of God bonded us together.
Amen.
Amen.
That's
so
right.
We're thankful that God brought us here. And that's the message of unity, is to show love for pastors, for the streets, for political leaders. Because the Bible tells us that He died for all humanity.
Yes.
Not denominations, not doctrines, not different things that we go by on this earth, but He died for all humanity.
Yes.
And that's where the message that we bring.
Yes.
And I thank God for you letting us be here today that we can give that message out also, because we are privileged.
Yes.
We're privileged because God has chosen us. John 15:16 says that. I have chosen you, you have not chosen me.
That's right.
And I ordained you to go forth and bear fruit. Yes. And that's what we are following.
Exactly. Well, what really caught my attention is not only are you doing a lot of great works and good deeds for the kingdom of God, and it's to help people because you love people, but what really caught my attention is, it's like when the Apostle Paul said, listen, I came to this particular city and I came to you in the eloquence of my speech.
Amen.
And when he talks about that, he only got a few people born again. And now he came back again to that same city. And he said, now this time I'm not coming to you in the eloquence of my speech, because he was a brilliant man, spoke 5 different languages. But he said, I'm going to come to you in the demonstration of the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah.
And he began to release the power of the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah.
And the whole city was impacted and changed.
Amen.
For the glory of God. And I see that in you guys. That you not only you're preaching, not only you're doing some good works, but you're doing it with the power of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
You're demonstrating the power.
Thank you, Lord. Jesus said,
don't just preach it, demonstrate.
Hallelujah.
The kingdom of God is at hand. It is here. And he said, then go heal the sick, drive out demons, raise the dead, demonstrate that what you're saying is really here.
Amen.
Just don't say it, do it.
Come on.
And so you guys are doing it and saying it and showing that love behind it. And God is, because I tell people, listen, if you want the anointing of the Holy Spirit to manifest in your life, go do something. Yeah. Serve the Lord.
Amen.
This isn't going to happen until you're going to sit home and do nothing.
Yeah.
You're not going to experience the power of God. You get down on the streets or go whatever God's called you to do.
Mm-hmm.
Not everybody's called to do what you guys are called to do, but everybody has a calling. Everybody
Amen.
Has a gift. Everybody has an anointing. We're all part of the body of Christ, right? Some are the hands, some are the feet, some are the liver. You know what I'm saying? And so, but I was telling my church the other day, I said, when's the last time you thanked your liver for functioning, right? But if your liver stops functioning, you're dead.
That's it.
So your liver is important.
Mm-hmm.
So sometimes, Paul said, listen, sometimes it's the parts in the body that are not seen that may very well be the most important parts of the body of Christ.
Amen.
And so all of us are important to the body of Christ. What you're doing, the people who pray, the people who go out, the people, yourself that are up there in the front, you're like on the cutting edge, so to speak.
Mm-hmm.
But everybody's important.
Amen.
Everybody has a part. And so we just want to encourage people today that no matter what gift, what calling, what anointing, God wants to use them.
Amen.
And that you can do something significant for the
Amen.
Lord. And I know that you guys could always use help with your. And so you're on the south side of Milwaukee, you guys are down there every week. And all the time, and doing significant things for the glory of God. So we got a few minutes left on this segment here, but is there anything else, Pastor Al, that's on your heart that you would like to just kind of share?
I would say it's in my heart.
Yeah.
And sometimes I, when I'm in prayer, it's just heavy in my heart. And that is the unity of the pastors.
Mm, that's good.
Because we could get more done if the unity was there.
Yeah.
That's my heart desire.
Well, we got about 1 minute left in this segment. Why don't you go ahead and pray for that, Pastor Al? Let's just pray that I'm sure, because I know pastors are watching. I know that I've talked to them from time to time. They tell me they watch the Praise the Lord show. And let's just pray for that and just in general for the unity of the
Amen.
Body of Christ.
Heavenly Father, we just want to thank you for this time you have given us.
Yes.
We thank you that you are the God, that your eyes are over the righteous and your ears are open unto their prayers.
Yes, Lord.
You said the fervent prayers of a righteous man availeth much.
Mm.
And Lord, we just cry out to you for the unity that we need in Milwaukee, for pastors to come together and not looking at each other with the labels, but to look at each other as brothers in the Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Working for the same, and that is for the kingdom of God.
Mm.
We pray that your will be done. Help us to unite, and it will be done here on earth.
Yes.
Help us, Father, in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Amen.